Good morning, everybody. Thank you so much for watching this video. My name is Patrick Buxer. I'm the proud principal at Jackson Academy of Math and Music. We're making this video to share to parents about some of the wonderful opportunities here for our school and the community, and introduce you to some wonderful people for our kindergarten roundup. So parents, thank you so much for taking the time. The beautiful thing about our school is that we are a K-8 program where we allow students to build an amazing relationship with peers as they grow up and go through the years. I can speak for hours about the amazing research around K-8 programs in a school district, and I feel very fortunate to work with some of the most amazing teachers, support staff, and students that I've ever met in my 25th plus years as an educator. So on behalf of Morgan Hill Unified School District and Jackson Academy of Math and Music, I thank you for watching this video. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Vita Wedding. I am the secretary here at Jackson. We are looking forward to having our new kinder coming in, and I am in charge of enrollment. So please feel free to reach out and ask any questions you might have. I am here to help get you through the enrollment process. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Denise Purvis, and I'm the speech and language specialist here at JAM. My favorite thing about working at this school is my ability to get in and out of the classrooms and to actually be on this playground with your kindergarten children. I hope you enjoy your tour of JAM, and my door is always open. Thank you.
Okay, hi, my name is Mrs. Meehan. I teach kindergarten at Jackson Academy. And I've been teaching for a long time. I love teaching kindergarten because I love how the children at this age are like sponges and ready to learn. I want to provide them the opportunity to learn, practice the essential social, emotional, problem solving, and study skills that they need throughout the school years. Like one quote says, all I learn in kindergarten. I want to be part of that, that part of your children's life. My goal in kindergarten is to look at the whole child and develop the milestones that they will be using throughout the school years. I scaffold my teaching for them to learn according to their needs and maturity. All through the kindergarten day, I provide a lot of hands-on activities. We do a small group instruction where children share their ideas with others. A small group instruction and whole group instruction where we learn, turn and talk, and share ideas and learn more about other things. Our classroom is like a research center where children are always using their hands, looking at things, developing the language skills that they need to be successful throughout the school year. Children are discovering and sharing their ideas, and I take all their input, their ideas as a part of our learning. I could have lesson plans ready, but if one child asks a question that is an amazing question to answer, we look for answers and work together. So I'm learning at the same time as they are. Children discover their world through play, through laughter, and their learning is alive. Our entire school shares the same pedagogical focus and mission. And so we're welcome. My classroom is open for you if you come and observe and come and look at how the kindergarten classroom looks at Jackson. My doors are open, so come and see our amazing program.
Okay, hello future families at home. I am Mrs. Price, and I have taught here for 3 years, but I've been a teacher myself for 10 years. I came to JAM because I just loved the school here. My daughter was starting at JAM, and I wanted to make sure that I could come here and be here with her at school when I was here too. And the more I get to know the school, the more reasons I find out that it's just such a great place to be. We have a lot of great things going on here at our school. Not only are we a music school, so our students get to learn a lot about music and they have fun with that, but also this is a K-8, and I know that a lot of families really enjoy that aspect of it. It's really great to not have to worry about where your child is when they're moving on to middle school. We are, all the teachers here work really well together, so we have this seamless foundation going through where we can all work together in all the grade levels, and we get to know the students here and their families in a really meaningful way, having them here for so long with so many years. Another thing I love about this school is you will find that there are so many teachers here that are also parents. They have their kids also here going to this school, and that's one of the things that I love, because we all are able to share this connection between home and family, and we are able to, you know, help you at home. We understand what you're going through, and so it's just a really great place to be. I wouldn't change it any other way. This is the best school I've ever been at. We have a great principal, a great staff, we have happy students, and I just love teaching here, so I hope to see you one day soon.
Hi parents, my name is James Carlin, and I am the school psychologist at Jackson Academy of Math and Music. And I am really privileged to be a part of this team here. And I just wanted to talk and share a little bit about, Jackson is very much involved with music, as some of you might already know, but what I find out with music is it is so good for the social-emotional support for the kids. So if you just want to look around, we have all kinds of instruments, bongos, we've got bass, we've got cello. If you look over here, we've got all kinds of different instruments for the kids. And the neat thing about this, parents, is this actually starts in kindergarten. So we start working with these kids with kindergarten. Before you know it, they're actually learning new instruments as they get older in elementary school and as they go into middle school. And they actually learn to be playing in a band when they're in middle school. But it really all starts all the way down to kindergarten and to the support that we're able to give them through that. And we have the music teacher going into the classes, bringing her also to the room here and teaching these kids about instruments and how to play. And what I have seen in talking to some of these kids and just seeing all the way around is this is so good for social-emotional support, because it really helps them be able to connect with music. Another thing I just wanted to mention is we're also a PBIS school, which is Positive Behavior Intervention Supports. So we're really all about positive behavior. We're all about being able to learn how we can help your kids grow positively and learn to be better students. So I'm really excited about being a part of this, and I look forward to hopefully seeing you parents have your kids enrolled here at JAM. Thank you.
Music is a universal language that everyone deserves to be able to have the opportunity to be engaged in. We know that music is math, it's science, it's a foreign language, it's history,
it's art.
Scientific research has shown that playing a musical instrument is one of the few activities that actually engages both sides of the brain at the same time. And we know through scientific research that students who receive a music education on average test 7.5 points higher on IQ tests than students who do not have a music education.
These are just some of the wonderful side effects of studying music.
Music, although it's demanding and it requires focus and critical thinking, most of the time kids don't even realize the mental aerobics that their brains are going through while they're studying music, because music is fun and engaging. The music education that the students receive here at JAM is very well-rounded. I teach K-5 music, and although my pedagogical background is mostly rooted in my study of this through the Suzuki method, I fell in love with the Suzuki method because the Suzuki method is based on the premise that all children can learn music, that it's not true, like was once thought, that you had to inherit musical talent or be born with it. And now we know that if a child can learn to speak their native language, they can learn to play music. Most of all though, music helps us feel. It helps us be compassionate, helps us be sensitive listeners. It's the universal language that connects us as human beings. Research into the area has proven that
The earlier we start a music education, the better. The best benefits happen when we can start a music education before a child reaches the age of 7. Kids learn discipline and perseverance through a music education. When they see the results of their daily practice over a long period of time, they learn that they can accomplish anything they set their mind to. Not every child is going to become a music major, but we're also creating the sensitive listeners that will become the audiences of the future as well. Kindergarten, in addition to a general music education, we provide an opportunity to study the violin through the Suzuki method. And just as toddlers learn their native language by listening, the students are given daily listening of quality music that will serve as the model for their musical growth. They each get a weekly small group violin lesson, as well as early reading and rhythmic exercises. Ultimately, they get to play together in an ensemble, which connects them on a very, very special level. As the students progress through the grade levels, they will be exposed to the fundamentals of vocal music, as well as piano, keyboarding, recorders, and other wind instruments. They will ultimately have an opportunity to choose which instruments they would like to continue pursuing and become part of a larger ensemble, either orchestra or band. Each child is encouraged to reach their highest musical potential. The kids learn very early on that music is a cooperative and collaborative effort, and that they can express themselves artistically in a non-judgmental and cooperative environment. Our goal is to enrich the whole child, to help each child reach their maximum potential and to become fine human beings. Now, I would be remiss if I did not address the uncertainty of the times that lie ahead of us. None of us knows what it will look like a month from now or even a year from now. Now that your children have had to navigate new ways of learning as we are doing our virtual and distance learning due to the pandemic, I too have had to come up with new strategies for teaching. However, I want to assure you that I have been able to develop a curriculum that is stimulating and engaging, as well as fun and keeping us on track for our music learning. And even though so far this year we have not had those instruments in our hands to be able to play together, we're learning so much about music history and appreciation. We're learning to clap rhythms and read notation. I know that when we get back together again and we can get those instruments in our hands and play together, that your children are going to have a very strong foundation in music from which to build on.
Parents, thank you so much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed listening and learning about the school. Every year, we ring our gong at the first day of the school and the last day of the school. So, for our kindergarten roundup video, welcome to the 2021-2022 school year. Thank you very much. Have a great day.